Hey everyone, it's Nightlight 9, and in this video, I'm going to be going over the newest crossover banner that just dropped a few days ago, Terra's Garb and Terra's Rod, and talk about what I think about it. So, if we come in here, you can see new weapon is called Terra's Rod, the new gear is called Terra's Garb. I'm going to start with the garb first because there's a little bit less to say about it. Starting out, you've got physical and magical ward. That's going to be plus 15% to your physical and magical defense. Definitely good. As far as that particular R ability, it's slightly worse than her anniversary one. So from a purely defensive standpoint, I would say the edge goes to the anniversary one, which gives 20%, I believe, to physical and magical defense. But then it also has buff debuff extension plus, which is good for 60%. And that does not, it basically stacks on top of regular buff debuff extension. So I think this is pretty nice. I would say it's a very solid piece of gear. I don't think it's a must, but it definitely is nice to have. But that'll be kind of a decision that you might want to make based on how many stamps you get if you decide to go for at least one copy of the weapon, which is going to be my suggestion. So looking at Terra's Rod here, it does a lot of things. I mean, one thing basically with a lot of different options. So it's got flat magical damage, non-elemental, and then it's got three different breaches on it. It also has boost HP and buff debuff extension, very similar to Kimura Wand. And I think that this is really nice to have on a weapon like this, especially if you're going to be main-handing it. As far as the abilities go, though, Cure All is definitely nice to have on a weapon like this. The magic attack boosts, probably not nearly as necessary. Would be really cool if it had some sort of, boost to a materia that's going to be supported here, like a fire and an ice or a thunder, something like that. But that's kind of nitpicking at this point. We're going to go ahead and look at Obi-Wan. So as usual, we're looking at one of Tom Rom's cards, and I love the detail he put into this one, you know, really giving it the flair for Final Fantasy VI, because that is where we are right now. as usual, we're not really too concerned with the damage that this weapon does, unless you're probably like a really high level account. So 470 to 540 is just kind of whatever. What we're mostly concerned with is whether or not we go from mid to high, which we're not going to get till OB6. You do get a slight boost on the R abilities. But this is just to show you what it would do. I'm not necessarily recommending that you Obi-Wan this. You can, it's fine. But ultimately, I think getting one copy is a pretty good idea. And this is the reason why. So looking at this at 5-star, what it does particularly well is it gives you a lot of flexibility. One weapon can do three different breaches: fire, ice, and thunder. It also hits all enemies on each one of these breaches, which, depending on the content you're doing, a lot of the content we've had thus far only really needs a single target for the most part, but we have been seeing more and more where it's very useful to be able to do both, looking at things like the double summons and some of the other content we've had, where it's nice, especially when, like, I'm thinking of, it's Ramu and Shiva, where they do the, you know, protecting thing where, you know, you really don't want to have to start switching back and forth. That is very nice, and I can only imagine, since they're giving us access to this, that that is going to become more and more of a thing. So I think this weapon is going to be something you want to pick up. However, it starts out at mid potency, and so the value you get from one copy is actually quite good. For that reason, I do think getting a copy is good, but whether or not you want to take it to OB6, I mean, yes, it's very nice to have high potency right out of the gate. However, it does still stack to high even at 5-star. But on the buff debuff extension, you're going to be a little bit short if you're not main-handing it, because at 27, you wouldn't quite have enough to get you to 15 points. I don't know if that's a concern for everybody, but just something to be aware of. But then when you get to OB10, and I believe it even OB7, at OB7, you would have enough to have 30 points here, I believe. At OB10, it basically just increases duration. 35 seconds is quite long. 750% is really not bad for everything else it's doing. This is going to be 4 ATB, which I think is fair because it's doing all enemies. And again, you're going to have a top tier HP boost as well. So the weapon's really good. Here's the reason that I'm not going to go for OB6 on this. I'm pulling up Red's weapons here. And I guess if you can't see them, I'll move myself briefly so that you can see. I've just kind of selected all of these to use as a kind of an example because Red 13 is my primary breacher. And here's the reason why. Looking at his weapons, we have Silver Collar. This can do wind and water for 3 ATB. Same thing, base stats are mid, and then it goes up to high at OB6. Next, we have Ivy Collar. That does fire and ice. So now we're already covering 4 different elements, and then a 5th one here with Seaside Collar. Now, the big difference is that Seaside Collar does cost 4 ATB, which makes it feel a lot clunkier than bringing in the other two. And then on top of that, I just added in Junk Collar because magic attack decrease is something that's really important and something that we don't really have access to with Aerith. And so that comes into play in a lot of battles. So I put that on there as well just because he is really good for debuffing. And then last, I also added Gold Collar. There's another one called Canyon Collar that does the same thing with magic defense down to all enemies. So those are kind of some things you combo together usually if you're doing, let's say, magic attack or if you need the magic attack debuff on the enemy. And the reason I bring those up is I have all of the primary breach weapons to OB6. I am one away from having the Junk Collar here that does the magic attack decrease to OB6. So I've invested a lot, and I would imagine that many players that have been playing for a while have been investing in either Red or somebody similar to that to do their breaching. And so based on, you know, just the amount of crystals we get, this doesn't do enough for me to say, okay, I'm going to spend maybe all of my crystals trying to get this to OB6. And the fact that it's a crossover means that it's limited, which means there's only going to be very few other times or opportunities you have to pull for this weapon. So I'm just not ready to throw everything in for something that does not bring something new enough or strong enough to the table that I don't feel like, I guess, something to the table that I don't think I can already kind of work around with what I have and what I've already invested in. So if you're a light spender or a dolphin or definitely free to play, I just think that the value here isn't quite enough to want to go past one copy. But I do think one copy is going to be very, very good, even if you don't need it all that often. I mean, how often do you need to breach, you know, multiple enemies at once? I don't know. Maybe more in the future, maybe not. But even if you don't, it is very versatile in 3 different breaches on one weapon. And one copy is not that hard to get. You need 6 stamps. So it's good to pick up because it's limited, just in case you do need it. And I think that there are going to be several use cases for this. So that's my suggestion, is that if you're saving crystals for big things like I am, I would hold off. I'm probably not even going to necessarily pull for this until I see the other banners. But at this moment, I do plan to go 6 stamps for this. As far as whether or not I get the costume, that's also probably something I'm not likely to go for, just because I do have the anniversary garb for the defense, which also gives some extra heal on that. And this one, you're really mixing defense with the buff debuff, which is great, but I don't think it's enough to warrant me spending, you know, potentially another, I don't know, 12,000-18,000 crystals to get that costume. Those are my thoughts. I'd be really interested to know what you guys think. Are you getting one copy? Are you going for broke or skipping it altogether? And if so, if you're skipping, I'd really be interested in hearing your thoughts. Subscribe for future content if you're not already. If you are, I appreciate each and every one of your support. And as always, thanks for watching.